if I were to buy a put option with a $50 exercise price, and if I were to buy it for $10, then the value of my position, the payoff for that put option at the maturity, or at the expiration, I should say, at the expiration of the option, depending on what the stock price is at expiration, would look like this. If the stock price goes to zero, then the put option is worth 50, because I could buy the stock at zero and exercise my option to sell at 50, at putting the stock to someone else at $50. All the way to if the stock becomes worth 50, then my put option, I wouldn't need to exercise it, because why would I? It's worthless to have the option to sell something at 50, where you can just sell it in the sell the actual stock in the open market, or buy the stock at 50. So then the put option becomes worthless for a stock price above that. Now this is the payoff diagram, and this is when we just think about the value at expiration. If we think about the actual profit and loss at expiration, it would look like this. It would just be shifted down by $10, because we have to pay $10 to get this value. So if the stock is worth zero, the put option itself is worth 50, but I've spent $10 to get it, so the profit is going to be $40. And so then at 50, I wouldn't exercise the put option, so I've lost the $10 that I spent on the option. So my payoff diagram would look like, I want to draw it relatively neatly. My payoff diagram would look like this. Once again, this payoff diagram just incorporates the price of the option, so it's the actual profit. This is just the value at expiration, depending on what the value of the stock is at expiration. Now, this is just a situation if you were to buy an option, but there has to be someone on the other side of the contract, someone who's agreeing to buy the option for you. So you could actually have the writer. You could actually have the writer of the put. The payoff diagram we just showed is the person who owns the put, but someone else had to have created the put. They said, oh, you know what? I will give you the right. I will give you the right to sell me the stock at $50 up to some expiration date. So what does their payoff diagram look like? Well, if this guy is going to be able to make $50, this guy's over here, the writer of the put is going to lose $50. He's going to have to essentially go out. He's actually going to have to buy that $50 put, or buy that $50 stock from this person, because he has to uphold his side of the transaction. But he's buying something for $50 that's worthless, because based over at this end of the axis, the stock would be worth nothing. So he's taking a $50 loss, all the way to him not having to do anything, because the put holder won't actually exercise their option if the stock price is 50. So their payoff diagram is going to look like this. So you can see it's actually the mirror image of the payoff diagram of the person on the other side of the contract. And if you were to add these two payoff diagrams, you would be neutral, because all of the money is exchanging hands between the buyer and the seller of the put. If you look at the actual profit or loss, if the put is not exercised, then the writer of the put essentially just got a free $10. He sold the put to this guy for $10. He created the put and sold it to that guy. He gets $10. If the put's not exercised, he gets to keep that $10. But then if the stock goes down and he's forced to buy the stock from the owner of the put, he has to buy it because that's his side of the deal, then all of a sudden he loses money. So he would go, if all the way down, if the stock is worth nothing, he is forced to buy something for $50 that's worth nothing. He would take a $50 loss, but he made the $10 on the actual price of the option, so it would be a negative $40 profit. And so his profit and loss would look like this. But once again, these are the mirror images of each other.